Leatherbacks are the largest turtles on Earth, growing up to 7 feet long and weighing more than 2,000 pounds. These sea turtles are among the most highly migratory animals on Earth, some traveling up to 10,000 miles a year between their nesting and feeding grounds. Prevalent in every ocean except the Arctic and Antarctic, the species overall is declining, more so in the Pacific. In the eastern Pacific, the Mexican population was once thought to be the largest in the world and has experienced an alarming decline.
This trajectory of decline that we've seen, and actually collapse, we're talking about only 20 or 30 turtles nesting every year, where thousands used to just 40 years ago. That's the kind of dramatic decline.
The Western Pacific population has been declining steadily, and it's particularly critical to act now before it collapses, while there are enough turtles in nests to respond to conservation measures. But threats to all leatherbacks in the Pacific need to be addressed.
The top threats to populations are uncontrolled coastal development, all the bad stuff on the nesting beaches, egg harvest, poaching of the females, predation on the eggs by dogs and pigs. Deforestation makes the sand too warm and dry for and the eggs don't hatch. Another one is incidental capture in fishing gear. During their vast migrations, they get caught in fishing gear throughout the Pacific. And finally, marine debris, which the leatherbacks mistake for their favorite food, jellyfish, and they choke on those.
Protecting leatherbacks in U.S. waters alone is not enough to ensure the continued existence of the species. The highly migratory nature of Pacific leatherbacks requires cooperation and international collaboration. NOAA is focusing on partnerships with Mexico, Central America, Indonesia, Papua New Guinea, and the Solomon Islands in the Pacific.
Our action plan promotes a holistic recovery strategy that addresses all the sources of mortality. So that's basically ensuring that the remaining nesting sites are protected and the nests produce as many hatchlings as possible. And then secondly, in tandem with that, is reducing the fisheries related mortalities. We're working with international partners to incentivize community participation on the nesting beach conservation and developing alternative livelihood programs that wean communities off leatherback resources and introduce alternative methods for food and income. Recovery is going to take a long time, on the order of 20 to 30 years at least, before we see some of these actions bear fruit. But here in the U.S., we can all help leatherbacks by making seafood choices, for instance, that support sustainable fishing practices. And beachgoers can certainly do their part by keeping our oceans clean of plastic debris, picking up marine litter, particularly plastic bags.
Together with our partners, we are strengthening protection and conservation efforts to ensure a future for leatherbacks, helping them to survive and once again thrive in the waters of the Pacific Ocean.